Ayushi Verma from Investor Learn Academy, and I welcome you all to this channel. In the last video, we talked about the company analysis, where we have seen the factors affecting the company analysis, how do we evaluate the company's fundamentals and risk associated with different businesses. In this video, we'll talk about the Porter's Five Forces framework, and this is a method for analyzing the competition of a business and helps to explain why various industries are able to sustain different levels of profitability. This model identifies and analyzes five competitive forces that shape every industry and helps determine an industry's weakness and strengths. It is frequently used to identify an industry's structure to determine corporate strategy. Porter's model can be applied to any segment of the economy to understand the level of competition within the industry and enhance a company's long-term profitability. To understand it thoroughly, you need to analyze the fundamental position of the company in its industry. This position can be understood with the help of the following five competitive forces. First, competition in the industry. Second, the threat of new entrants in the industry. Third, the threat of substitute. Fourth, the bargaining power of buyers, and fifth, the bargaining power of sellers. Now let's have a look at each one of them in detail. First, competition in the industry. For most industries, the intensity of competitive rivalry is the biggest determinant of the competitiveness of the industry. Having an understanding of the industry rivals is vital to successfully marketing a product. Positioning depends on how the public perceives a product and distinguishes it from the competitors. An organization must be aware of its competitors' marketing strategies and pricing and also be reactive to any changes made. The larger the number of competitors along with the number of equivalent products and services they offer, the lesser the power of a company. Suppliers and buyers seek out a company's competition if they are able to offer a better deal or lower prices. Conversely, when competitive rivalry is low, a company has greater power to charge higher prices and set the terms of deal to achieve higher sales and profits. According to Porter, the competition is the most intense when the following conditions are met. First, there are numerous competitors and most of them have similar size and value. Second, the growth is slow, causing a rush for the major share of the market. Third, the products or services offered by all the companies in the sector are homogeneous. This makes it easier for the consumer to switch from one provider to another. Fourth, in sectors where the product is perishable or the fixed price is very high, companies are tempted to cut prices. Fifth, if the company wants to increase its output, it needs to do so in large increments for the expansion to be the cost efficient. Sixth, the exit barriers are very high. Seventh, the competitors are highly diverse lot with different goals and personalities. Second, the threat of new entrants in the industry. Porter lays a lot of emphasis on the barriers to entry in any industry. New entrants put pressure on current organizations within an industry through their desire to gain market share. This in turn put pressure on prices, cost, and the rate of investment needed to sustain a business within the industry. The threat of new entrants is particularly intense if they are diversifying from another market, as they can leverage existing expertise, cash flow and brand identity, as it put a strain on existing company's profitability. Barriers to entry restrict the threat of new entrants. If the barriers are high, the threat of new entrants is reduced, and conversely, if the barriers are low, the risk of new companies venturing into the given market is high. Barriers to entry are advantages that existing established companies have over new entrants. Imagine a company launching a path-breaking product or service in a particular industry. If the barriers to entry are low, then new firms can easily surpass them and replicate the business model turning competitors. Third, the threat of substitutes. Substitute product and services are not from the same market segment. There are some products and services where the customer can easily switch to substitute the products. Hence, when the demand for one increases, the another experiences a drop. This can impact the performance of the company and investor perception, not allowing the share price to truly flourish. For example, if the price of the coffee increases, then the coffee drinker might move to tea or another beverage. Hence, before buying the share of a company, look at the products and services offered and the substitutes available in the market. Based on this observation, you will be able to assess how well the company is positioned to manage any substitute product or services threatening its profit. Also, companies that have fewer or no substitute tend to price their products and services higher and have higher stock prices. Michael Porter lists the following major potential factors of threat of substitutes. First, buyer propensity to substitute. Second, relative price performance of substitute. Third, buyer switching cost. Fourth, perceived level of product differentiation. Next, number of substitute products available in the market. Next, ease of substitution. Next, availability of close substitutes. Fourth, the bargaining power of buyers. The bargaining power of buyers is the ability of buyers to drive the prices down. It is affected by how many buyers or customers a company has, how significant each customer is, how much it would cost a company to find new customer or market for its output. A smaller and more powerful client base means that each customer has more power to negotiate for the lower prices and better deals. According to Porter, buyers can force sellers for better pricing under the following conditions. First, the market is concentrated or purchases are made in large volumes. Second, the company offers products that are standardized or undifferentiated. For example, in the paper industry, most manufacturers create standardized products. Hence, buyers can form a manufacturer to sell at a market prices. Third, some companies purchase products from other companies and resell them at a lower margins. Hence, they can push the prices lower. One can assess the bargaining power of buyers by assessing the concentration of buyers, volume of transactions, sensitivity of customers, etc. This can help you to understand how the profits of the company that you are looking to invest in get can impact it in the long term. Fifth, the bargaining power of suppliers. The bargaining power of suppliers is also described as the market of inputs. Suppliers of raw materials, components, labor, services to the firm can be a source of power over the firm when there are few substitutes. Let's say if you are making biscuits and there is only one person who sells flour. You have no other alternative but to buy it from them. Suppliers may refuse to work with the firm or charge excessively high prices for unique resources. Michael Porter lists out the following major potential factors of bargaining power of suppliers. First, supplier switching cost relative to firm switching cost. Next, degree of differentiation of inputs. Third, impact of inputs on cost and differentiation. Fourth, presence of substitute inputs. Fifth, strength of distribution channel. Sixth, supplier concentration to firm concentration ratio. And seventh, supplier competition. Now the next question arises, how to analyze the stocks with the Porter's five forces model. Once we have understood the Porter's five forces, we will be able to evaluate the company's competitive position in the industry. This is a qualitative parameter that is usually ignored by most of the investors. Here are some pointers to help you to use this tool efficiently. The first step is to gather information about all the forces. Here are some of the factors that you need to gather information on. First, under the competition in the industry, the following points can be considered. How many competitors does the company have? What are the exit costs? What is the size of the industry and at what rate is it growing? Does the industry have product differentiation or homogeneity? What is the size of the competitors? What are the customers loyal to the brands in the industry? Are there any threats to horizontal integration? Under the threat of new entrants in the industry, the following points could be taken. How much capital does a new company need to enter the industry? How do existing companies respond to the new entries? Are there any legal barriers to entry? How is the access to the supplier and distributor market? Can a new company achieve economies of scale easily? Are there any government regulations that cause a barrier to entry? Under the threat of substitutes, the following points can be considered. How many substitutes exist for the company's product and services? How are the substitutes performing? What cost do buyers have to bear while switching to substitutes? Under the bargaining power of buyers, the following points can be taken. How many buyers are there? What is the size of each purchase? What is the cost associated with a buyer switching a supplier? How many substitutes exist? Are buyers sensitive to price changes? Under the bargaining power of sellers, the following points can be considered. How many sellers or suppliers are there? What is the financial strength of each supplier? Can the supplier easily find substitute metals? Do the suppliers hold difficult to find materials? What is the cost of switching to alternate materials? Second step is to start analyzing each aspect carefully, trying to determine how each force impacts the industry and the company that you are planning to invest in. You can use this table for quick reference to analyze the attractiveness of an industry. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. We will meet you on next Monday with a new topic. So till then, happy learning and be safe.